The next circuit is the encoder, which is the inverse operation of the decoder. In decoder, we have n inputs and 2 power n possible outputs. Here we have 2 power n or fewer inputs, and we have n output lines. The output corresponds to the binary encoding of the input. This is the truth table of 8 to 3 encoder, that is we have octal to binary converter here, okay, and we need to have out of 8 inputs we need to have exactly one of the inputs to be 1, okay. So this corresponds to the octal 0, and we will generate the output of octal 0, which is 000 in binary. And if it is, say, D4 is 1, we should generate 100 and so on. Okay, so there is a limitation in using the encoder, because we need to restrict the input to be only one input to be 1, rest of them to be 0. And we cannot expect the users of the encoder to be well behaved. Okay, if we say you need to switch on only one switch out of the 8 at a time, okay, the user might not listen to the instruction. It's possible that the user might switch on more than one switch, say for example D0 and D5 together, then what will happen to the output? Okay, the output will not be interpretable, or it is a valid output. So we need to have some restriction to the input which the user cannot violate. Thus we have the priority encoder. We can give the priority to the input, okay. Say for example here we have given the priority to the higher order bits, that is if D2 is 1, irrespective of the value of D0 and D1, okay, D0, even if D0 is, D1 is 1 and D0 is 1, we are going to give the priority only to D2. That means that we will generate only 10 as the output. We are going to ignore the lower order bits, okay, and we have a valid bit also in this circuit. Why? Because when D0 is 1, the output is all 0. Okay, we do not know whether the circuit is giving an output or the circuit is not operating. Okay, so we need to know when the circuit is operating or when I can interpret the output to be a valid output. So we have valid bit as output. When all the D's are zeros, okay, the validity of the output is 0. That is, any output that appears will not be taken as a valid output. So that's why we have X here. And when D0 is 1, the output should be 0, 0 for X and Y. And this is a valid output. So we have valid bit to be 1. When D1 is 1, we should have D2 and D3 to be 0, but D0 can be anything. D0 can be either 0 or it is 1. In that case, we are going to generate 0, 1 as the output and so on. Okay, so let's implement this circuit. So we'll find what is the output for X. We have 4 inputs, D0, D1 and D2, D3. Okay, and we have the binary bit combinations given in gray code sequences, and this is a 4 bit map because we have 4 input, and we have X to be 1 for these 2 rows, okay, and we have X's here, and X's they don't care for the input 000, so we have a X here, and these X's can be either 0 or 1, right? So this row, using this row, we can generate 4 rows in the input, right? So we have 0, 0, 1, 0, for which the output is 1. Then we have 0, 1, 1, 0. We have 1, 0, 1, 0. and finally 1110. All these four combination will get 1 as output. So let's see, we have 0010, we have 0010 as 1, we have 00, we have 01, we have 0110, so this is also 1. We have 10 and 10, so this is 1, and we have 1110, we have 11 and 10, so all these four rows are 1 for 10. Okay, so we have 10 and all the D0, D1 will vary. So all these rows corresponding to 10 will be 1. Similarly, we have to have the combination. So we will have 8 combinations for D3 to be 1, which is D3. This column, these two columns correspond to D3, and these are the 8 combinations that we will get for D3 to be 1. So we have marked all these columns to be cells to be 1. Now we can simplify. Okay, we can combine these 8 ones together. This is one block which corresponds to D3. And we can combine these two blocks together and combine, and we can get D2. Okay. So this is the expression for X. Similarly, we can generate the expression for Y, which corresponds to, so there is only one bit, so we'll have two rows corresponding to this one and two ones here. Okay, so 0 1 and 1 0 0 0. Okay, so we have two rows to be 1 corresponding to this output, and there are 8 ones corresponding to this row. Okay, and we can simplify and get the expression, which is D3 or D1 D2 bar. And valid bit is D0 plus D1 plus D2 plus D3. Okay, because it's all 1 here and it is 0 only for this one. So we can implement the circuit for the priority encoder. So this is the circuit for X, for generating X, because it's going to get D2 or D3, and this is going to be D1 D2 bar or D3, and valid bit is D0, this is D0, this is D1, and this is D2 or D3. Okay, so these two comes from here, so we have the valid bit. So only when the valid bit is 1, we will interpret the result of X and Y.